Wouldn't be a Sunday morning without some oval clocks, would it? Today we are working on that guy. I'm working at pointing on this thing. The Power Color Hellhound RX 6600 XT Samsung. This card is really, really quite good. Let me get rid of chat here. That's not relevant anymore. However, if you're watching last week on the 6600 non-XT, I do feel like that card is slightly more efficient. So obviously there's going to be a variation between a Hellhound and an Asus Duel, but we have the most desirable memory type on each one, and this card doesn't seem like it's a golden sample, but it honestly seems like it's just as good, if not better, a sample as that Asus was last time. So all things considered, I do think that it's probably worth looking at the regular 6600 over the 6600 XT, unless they're the same price, or your power is cheaper, or you're looking for just that little bit of edge on core algorithm hash rate. So, a lot of this testing was done in MMPoS, full disclosure. Hive shell was not working for like 3 days, and the whole thing's been a little bit wonky for the last 3 weeks. But I did come back and finish a lot of the testing and rerun a couple of results just to confirm that they were good in HiveOS later. So all of this was done with ROCm 5.6 drivers and the two different kernels between the Hive beta and the current MMPoS. So all that out of the way, the initial testing I did on LOL Miner on Flux showed that the best we could do was kind of like 0.47, 0.48 efficiency, which isn't great. But then we got into Hive and we got Mini-Z loaded. Mini-Z does tend to run a little bit lower, a little bit higher hash rate and a little bit higher efficiency. So just kind of win-win there. And we did end up at 23.71 sols at 0.515 efficiency. So pretty good efficiency, but the hash rate's not great. You can still get almost 0.5 at 30 sols or 29 sols. Probably better. Nexa hash rate, don't use these with Nexa. It's not offensive or anything, but it's like 20% worse than the equivalent same NVIDIA card, so just run Nexa on NVIDIA. Dynex, again, I come back to the miner still not being like fully in place. This was run in MMPoS, and I could not push the chips command argument to it. So ideally, we want to run these right now with 256 chips, according to Zapirate, and that gets us the best POUW hash rate. I did briefly see 3.1 kilohash on that, but this result here is a split between POW and POUW, which is not conducive to this card. So we're showing 2.1 kilohash roughly here for 49 watts, and that's 36 hash to the watt. However, we did get up to 39 hash to watt, dropping it just a little bit on hash rate. So it's still good. The metric I showed on here still says 35 or better is considered good. I still think that's fair. Especially when you loop NVIDIA into it, but miners are getting better. 1.0 miner is getting better. BZ miner is getting better. So at some point I will be revising that, probably up to 45 or 50 hash to watt. They're okay at Dynex right now. They're not great. They used to be great. Kyla coin I ran, let's see here. Is that good? 9 efficiency is good. We did 7.3. Not great. This algo was a little bit weird. I had to run way more voltage and quite a bit lower clock, which I don't really fully understand. The core clock is wrong. I was running this 1800. But that wasn't as bad as Carlson. Carlson, I full stop had to run this 100 megahertz lower and get rid of the SoC VDD max. Otherwise, it would just instantly hang and crash. Oh, I missed the hash rate. Dang it. Shoot. You know, let's run that right now. Why not? Carlson. Let me push that to the miner while we're waiting. Sorry, you guys are getting a taste of the actual stream. I'll have to readjust the OCs. We'll do that right at the end, I promise. We will fill in the Carlson data to get an efficiency number there. Radiant, we crossed the 10 megahash per watt, or 10 hash per watt. That's where I kind of draw the line for good. Ironfish, I really want to see 150 or better. We're at 144, so definitely some room for improvement there. Aletheum, really good. We're at 18. Anything above 15 is good. Anything above 18 is really good. So these are Aletheum monsters. Ergo, over 1 megahash per watt, even at hardware power, so we're doing really well there. ETC hash 0.548. I would have expected to see this closer to 0.6, like the 6600, especially considering the hash rate is exactly the same, but we do have a little bit more core overhead, and I think that's coming into play here. So, Pigeon, 0.151, not great, and the hash rate's extremely low, so I'd recommend against that. And Kapow, good, really good. So 0.228, 15.34 megahash, a little bit worse efficiency, a little bit higher hash rate. So just keep that in mind. Now let's move back to the last one we had, Carlson. Let's push this overclock in, shall we? We are running 1700 core clock, 690, 650. We are running 1 for memory clock and 1100 for memory voltage. So let's go ahead and get a Hive Shell session running. And let's see what we end up at. The 370 is probably going to be fairly close to where we end up at. But with the memory locked down to 1 here, that's the same as MMPoS, Smart Memory Tune, Compute Heavy, Aggressive. It's going to run the same sort of memory clock. So it's just downclocking it as much as it possibly can in the interest of putting all of the power envelope that you're feeding the card into the core. So we'll see if the shell comes up, but worst case, we're looking at, there it is, 386. So, and we're looking at an efficiency of 9 megahash per watt. That's very good. So Carlson, 386, 9.89. That brings us up to... it's 7, I think, is where I drew the line on that one, 7 or 8. So it's good, but it's not 40 series good. There are the hash rates for the Power Color Hellhound Samsung Memory RX 6600 XT. Again, this is a Samsung memory card. It's not a golden sample by any stretch. And I think the regular 6600 is a better buy, which, boy, I wasn't expecting that at the beginning of tonight. So thanks for watching. I will see you guys all next week. Possibly the 6700 XT, possibly a 40 series, because I just bought a bunch more 40 series FEs. Thanks for watching either way. Have a good week.